And Chris, for the Cardinals to have any shot to reach their objectives in 2021, they're going to need Jack Flaherty to be the top five Cy Young finisher he was 2 years ago, not the guy who had an ERA of upwards of five a season ago. And speaking of which, the PECOTA projections for the 2021 season have been released, and they don't think much of the Cardinals' chances, do they? Sitting there in third place at break-even, 81-81. Your thoughts?
Yeah, it's stupid. I mean, I don't pay any attention to this. Never have. But I do not like that. I do not like the Brewers. You can't say the Brewers right now are a 90-win team, which is what they got them at 89-73. That they have the Cubs blew too high. Cardinals just, would they do this projection before Arenado showed up? I mean, that's a ridiculous number. The Cardinals, by rote, will win 80 games. If I play in a team, winning culture, bad division, they figure out a way to win 80, 81 games, and now you add Arenado. Yeah, I don't like it. There's a lot of these I don't like. I don't know if you're going to go through division by division, but I certainly don't like the Cardinals. I think the Mets, if you want to show the Mets, they're way too high at 96. A team that always underachieves, that does not have a winning culture at all. You cannot put the Mets at 96 and 66. I mean, that is absolutely ridiculous. And then you put the Braves down at 82-80. The Braves, who have done nothing but win in the last 3 years, who brought in some pitchers, get Soroka back, came within an out or a bloop hit of going to a World Series last year, and somehow now they've gotten worse at 82-80. I mean, who figures this stuff out? What, these war computations? It's the dumbest thing in the world. I don't like that either, so that's two I don't like. The American League East, I'm okay with. I mean, I don't think there's a major problem there. I'm with you, Bruce. I heard you talk about it before. The White Sox should not be 83-79. Now, I don't like trendy teams, and the White Sox are a trendy team. And trendy teams, if you know how to play over-unders, trendy teams are dangerous. Stay away. And the White Sox are a very trendy team. But in that division, where there really isn't a dominant ball club, and you get 36 cracks at Kansas City and Detroit, you should be able to get a little higher than 83 wins if you're the White Sox. 88-89 would be fair. 83 is way too low for them. I think the Indians might be a little too high at 86, the White Sox. I think the Astros are probably a little too high in the American League West. I don't like them at 93. I know that's a bad division, and I don't know who I would take to win it. But I think the Astros, to ask them, they were 29-31 last year. I don't know where they've gotten that much better. I don't know if I can give them a record of 24 games over 500. So there's about three, five, six. There's about eight or nine of these, and I think you probably agree. And I don't care about standings. You can't predict standings. You predict win totals. There's about eight or nine of these I do not like as we begin spring training in a week or so. Go ahead.
Yeah, I very much agree with you on your thoughts on Milwaukee. I thought it was an inspired pick to put him in first place because I think people have gotten a little too gaga over the Cardinals. You know, the Brewers are going to get Lorenzo Cain back. They've got some very interesting pitching there, both at the front end of the rotation and the back end of that bullpen. So I could see them giving the Cardinals a run for their money, but I agree with you. In that division, if you get anybody above 85 wins, it's mildly surprising outside of the Cardinals. And, you know, conversely, on the NL East, it's sort of the same type of deal. I wouldn't be stunned in the least if the Braves were a high 90-win team. But when you look at the depth of that division, it's a stretch to predict anybody, you know, finishing with upwards of 100 wins, let alone a team that hasn't made the postseason for the better part of a half decade. So I can't quibble with you with the Mets either. That's way, way too ambitious. And then, there's just no way the White Sox are a slightly above 500 team. And I also don't think there's any way they finish behind the Cleveland Indians in that division either. So those would be the main points that I would take umbrage with as far as.
Yeah, I think the biggest oversight, and I think San Diego, 96 wins for the Padres is too high too. The Padres, you can't tell me the Padres can win 96 games. I mean, 90, but not 96. But the big oversight to me would be Atlanta. If you ask me for one that I think is just absolutely absurd, it's the Braves. You have to, when you do these things, and I'm assuming these aren't computers picking these numbers, there has to be an element of common sense. There has to be an element of winning culture. There has to be an element, you know, they're the Braves, they deserve more respect than 80 wins or 81 wins, and PECOTA doesn't give you that. There's no intangible listed with PECOTA. Now, you know, so the Braves, who have done nothing but make the playoffs and win both postseason games in the last whatever it might be, how do you get them at 82 and 80? And that is absolutely ridiculous. Again, I don't want to put them at 100, but I mean, they have to be around 90, 91 wins. So that's the biggest one to me that I do not like. Bruce and I, you were on the same page. I think it's an easy to knock that.